La Ferrassi 1 was a Neanderthal male who lived in southern France between 50 and 70,000 years ago. His is the most complete skull from the species that's ever been found. In fact, it's debated whether they actually belong to a separate species from us. It's recently become clear that we interbred. Most people from outside of sub-Saharan Africa have some Neanderthal DNA, but the circumstances aren't clear. For all we know, there might have been hundreds of instances of interbreeding, and only a small number resulted in fertile offspring. We might be the descendants of the exceptions to the rule. The amount of DNA varies from about 1% to nearly 5%, and this isn't proportional to how long ago it happened or how many times it happened. It's proportional to how much of an evolutionary advantage these genes were. It makes sense, given that Neanderthals had evolved in the freezing European climate, that their DNA should be of some use to us. It includes genes related to fat storage, which would make sense, but it also includes genes associated with depression, tobacco addiction, and urinary tract disorders, which obviously it's hard to see an evolutionary advantage for. 8 Neanderthals were buried at the La Ferrassi site, including men, women, and children, and it looked as though they'd been deliberately buried there. LF1 was probably reasonably old, given the degree of wear on his teeth. It's reasonable to suggest Neanderthals didn't live far past the age of 40, as that's around the life expectancy of human hunter-gatherers living in harsh conditions. In my reconstruction here, I've made him look about 40 by today's standards, but given the conditions he lived in, he might have aged faster. So let's say he's about 35 in this picture. His teeth were worn at a strange angle. It's been suggested he used them for something other than eating, for instance holding a pelt as he scraped the flesh from it. I wanted this image to capture the humanity and the culture of the Neanderthals, and so I did it in the style of Rembrandt. You can see the Rembrandt portrait I've cropped to the side, which I've used as a reference for the colour scheme. Here I'm painting the central feather, the wing feather of a red kite. There's evidence of Neanderthals taking the feathers from birds without butchering them for meat, so it might be that they were using them for some sort of cultural practice. Here I'm imagining them sewn into the back of his scalp. Birds of prey and corvids were used mainly, so I've got 4 magpie feathers and a red kite feather here. I used myself as a reference for the pose and various reconstructions of LF1 for the face. I experimented a bit with putting some charcoal markings on his face, but I eventually went for red ochre. This is one of the easier to obtain pigments, along with yellow ochre, and Neanderthals living in France would have had access to it. Things like blue and green pigments would have been extremely hard to make and probably wouldn't have been worn until much later. I considered putting him in a fallow deer pelt, but this was too bright and detracted attention from the face. It made for a bad composition, so I went for a darker wool from a wild sheep or melanic chamois. Ultimately, looking back on it, it looks like I put a bit too much attention into the face and not very much into anything else, which results in the picture having a fairly flat look apart from around the facial area. But I'm quite proud of it. I think it's reasonably good. It's not the best it could be, but, you know, practice makes perfect. I hope to improve in the future. And thanks for watching.